I mean, the reason you start skating is because you're kind of anti-everything. You're not feeling this or that. That's why you picked up a skateboard. Something made you look at that guy riding a skateboard or whatever made you want to skate and went, wow, I want to do that.
When Chocalate started, it's more of like all my friends, you know, that I skate with and stuff. So it's dope because it's just like a family, you know. That's why I love skating with them. It was weird because when we first got on, like, I remember, I forget what magazine ran it, but it said like a multicultural team, because everyone that was on Chocalate at that time was like, Ben was Mexican, Shamil was black, like we had all these different races on the team. And like when I think of Chocalate back then, it was Gabriel and Paulo and Chico. Those were like our big pros back then. They just look right on their skateboard. When you watch them push, you're just like, wow.
I mean, because I didn't really know any other guys, you know, so I basically just talked with Keenan, and I guess he would talk to the guys, and he would just let me know, yeah, everybody's down. We talked to everybody, and it's cool, so it's just up to you whenever you want to do it. Then I was like, let's do it.
I think a lot of the tragedies, a lot of the bad things that happen pulled a lot of people together and made them closer. Like, you know, Daniel got shot, and that was a big thing.
This is my gunshot wound, like right here, and then right here, it went out. For the second time in 3 days, a high school graduation party ended in a rain of bullets. Like this quote right here, like this lady's like, they were running around like rats, some were banging on the door. They were carrying a kid, and that kid was like me.
I never knew anyone who got shot before, much less Daniel out of anyone. And like with the Keenan passing and stuff, I mean, it was like, wow, like, you know, shit could really go down. I think a lot of people on Chocalate that really were close to Keenan and girl, of course, put it down for him, subconsciously or not. You know what I mean? Whether they talk about it or not, some reason why you're going to skating is a little Keenan in there.
I mean, for a minute, it seemed like Chocalate was just stagnant, not really, you know, it was kind of weird with Stevie leaving and then Keenan passing away. And right around that time, it was just kind of dead. Like, you know, it was weird. And
now, since we got Mark and Kenny and Justin, we got Chris, and it seems tight now, so I'm happy with it.
You know, Girl and Chocalate, like, they're definitely down for you. It's just like, yeah, you're part of the family.
When I got on Chocalate, it was like, all of a sudden, I'm with these guys. It was almost like a culture shock, almost.
Mark and Kenny are just, like, perfect, like, for Chocalate. So I always, like, would think about Chocalate and, like, this is tight. Like, this is where I want to be.
I think they fit in just fine, man. I mean, they're why I skate, you know what I mean?
You would have maybe never thought they fit Chocalate, say, 5 years ago, even like, you know, when I got on, like, I didn't probably fit, but now, like, they just, Chocalate has such a strong look.
Yeah, I think it's a new chapter. I think it's looking good though.
It's an exciting point. It's like fun. We're about to go on our tour and it's the first time for all of us to do this. I've been on plenty of Chocalate tours, but never with MJ, never with Elridge or Kenny. So it's gonna be sick to go with those guys, you know? Everyone's gonna have a new experience from this. And that's why this is gonna be sick.
Just kind of got in that one van that day in Torrance, you know, like I just picked the van to get in and that was the crew, you know.
Like your van becomes your home, you know what I mean? Like your spot in your van is like your spot.
It's always a weird feeling at first because you don't really, you're getting in, you know you're driving, but you don't realize how that's going to be your home for the next 30 days, you know.
Driving out of LA was good. It was definitely like a family feeling also, like, all right, like, this is it. Like, we're all in the vans and we're all just heading out of Girl Chocolate parking lot and just getting on the freeway.
Denver, bitch.
Come on, dude. Fat Ollie. And then yeah. Pump the hell out of this. And pump hard.
Is it on? I'm talking mad shit, kid. Dropping in. Front tip. Gotta tighten my binding. Whoa. I'm gonna do an open five. One more. Oh, God. Yeah, man. Oh. Little ollie. Pivot on a couple. Into the whiffy moves. Yeehaw.
The splitter.
I'm fucking tired.
You guys okay in there? Oh my God, I feel crazy. The blood's rushing to my head. Ah!
Europe's funny. I think Mark like said it best.
It's almost like whatever your thoughts are, you know, commenting on something like quietly in your head, but it would just go straight to like verbal with Mike. And it's almost like whatever he was thinking, he would just be saying out loud. And a lot of it was just like comic relief slash narration like the whole time.
He just pretty much says what everyone is already thinking. He's rad.
Dude, my bad. I was skating at the skate park. What was I thinking? See these people gonna stand right there? But then you're gonna stop Yorkatron. Shifty, because I'm in the city. Hopefully I don't scrape or hang up. Oh, that would have sucked if I hung up. Ollie the kid. That's 180. I'll try a fakey tray, but I might fuck up. Oh, I didn't fuck up. How do you like that? Feeling it?
I'm feeling it.
Right on, thank you. Feeling it.
Break me, dog. You dead, you okay, man?
To the story I'm about to tell, another tale about that yell. Little girl once in the city sweet, 14 introduced to the street, started from weed, big smoke bouts before you could exhale, blunt in your mouth, champagne, glue you blue, now you need something else to do. A new how to try, a new place to go. Introduced to the A to the yo. House full of girls, old and young. Played on the table, taking one-on-ones. Used dollar bills just to snort the lines. You see the big girls do it, so of course it's fine. Cocaine enforced on your mind. Not blow, then they blow in your time.
Yo, ayo, yayo. Walk around with yayo. All in my nasal, I must have been crazy. Ayo, yayo. Walk around with yayo. All in my nasal, I must have been crazy.
Chopping and copping the kicks. Sublime people with they fits. Where you fit. When Fillmore Street is where you sit. Don't go in the house till you move as it. Work the day.
Hurt my knee being good as fuck. Ah, hurt my knee being, I can't believe it. Put the brace on. Oh my God, dude, please, please, I pray that I'm not coming. My career's gone, I'm done skating forever to be fucking. Oh my God.
This thing's supposed to prevent it from going side to side, yet it went side to side. I don't know what's wrong with my leg, but it sucks, dude. I'm not skating no more.
This hurts. It's not worth it.
That's scary. I couldn't believe it. That, you know, it's not good for Chocalate, you know, for the whole tour and everything, you know, for people are expecting to see York and stuff.
Everything wants me to skateboard. My mind is there. Like, I don't feel scared about hurting myself. I don't have that problem. Like, you know, I'll push it until I get hurt, which I did. Was just like that peace of mind goes a long way, and that's why I was like, all right, if I can't skate, I know I can hang out with the kids, or you know, I can do my little part and be a cheerleader or the mascot or whatever. You know, I find myself tripping on it, like, why aren't you like punching a wall right now? How can you be happy in this, you know, terrible time? But you know, it could always be worse.
Dude, I didn't ask for that fucking cover. Like, hey, put me on the cover. Sweet.
Kenny, it seems like he's supposed to be on a skateboard.
You could sit there and like watch him skate any spot, like over and over, and it's like you never get bored of it, you know?
Like just the way he's so like light-footed and like he's supposed to be on a skateboard, like that's what he's supposed to do.
One night, man, I was completely, couldn't move. So we're driving around just to look at spots, and I just wanted to go anyway. Next thing I know, Ty's asking me, like, oh, are you gonna skate? Oh, I'll warm up, whatever. Next thing I know, I'm rolling around the ground, just so delirious, no sleep.
What is it, like 1:30 right now? Skate a double set, a demo. Launched out of a bowl for like 15 minutes, slamming on my head.
Lagadar. That's Japanese for ragdoll.
I will turn into a freak and I will not care who's watching me or who's standing around, because that's, I'm just like completely involved up here. But the longer you try a trick and don't make it, the worse it gets, because you hate everything. Until you stop. If I don't make it and I stop trying and I'm just like, I'll do it another day, it's cool. And then as soon as I stop, then it just goes away.
It's like skating's always been the same, like from day one. That's always how you progress. You sat at a spot and you tried a trick for 2 hours and then you finally land it. And then you move on, and like, that's just the way skateboarding has always been.
He'll like always commit to a trick and just fall so hard, you know what I mean? And like, you rarely see that in people, but that dude will just, you know, just go for it.
Sometimes filming felt like retiring, like, you know, just trying to get one freaking trick and taking like 3 days to get it. I mean, that's the way it is.
I grew up never skating rails. I don't skate rails to this day. And then you see, you know, someone like Justin go up to a rail and just, you know, the way he goes about it, it's a different mind state, I guess.
He's definitely got the new tricks on lock. That's one thing. His warm-up is like his nollie nose grind, no matter the size.
To me, I can't really comprehend it. It's kind of weird. Like the kind of stuff that's going down on handrails these days, especially what that kid's doing, it's amazing.
People talk about how like Girl Chocolate is just a real close family sort of thing, and I'm like really new to that. Like I haven't been with these dudes for that long, and like it kind of felt cool going to different places, especially when we went to different cities and we showed up at skate shops and showed up at skate parks, like two big old vans, and we all just jump out and it's just like everyone walking together like, oh, the Chocolate team.
I mean, everyone's individuals, but at the same time we're all like supporting that individual, and we're all like as a unit, like, you know, going through this thing. And like you see guys get tired and like they're, you know, you'd be like, no, you got this, and like, you know, the things like that, like, you know, people can really pick you up. It's almost like we're all going through it together type of thing, you know.
Teamwork is the dream work type feel, you know? I think everyone felt like, okay, cool, it's a team effort to make this thing happen. So there's definitely that type of unity on the team.
Like, you can see everyone's personalities through their skating. Everyone on the team is so funny. Like Chico freestyle battles, you gotta love that.
Riddle, got no riddle on the rhyme. I'm about to bust my shit one more time. Send him back. Wherever he's from, Las Vegas. He ain't got nothing on the cheek stuff.
She's a black belt in karate.
Yeah, that's right. My name is Keith Go. And you ain't got
working
no
for
me.
The city.
She has to drop a beat. How about I just drop a verse? Make all these people curse and go back on.
It's demanding to defeat those evil.
What the fuck I gotta go through back here with this little demon?
I know she can be them. Oh, Yoshima, they don't believe me. But you won't let
me get a shot of this.
My van was just mellow. It was good. It was youthful. Everyone definitely like talked a lot, and we all watched comedies together. I just feel like a little bit more chocolatey.
Going to a Sugar Ray concert after this. Yeah. Up in Nashville.
What sort of music do you like?
Hip hop.
Like a certain point in the tour, I had like a feeling, but I just started to feel like, you know what, this is actually fun. You know, like we were at the gas station at 1 o'clock in the morning playing soccer, and like me, I'm all about like what are we doing? We gotta get going. Like we gotta get to the hotel and go to bed. Like, you know, this is insane. But when I finally like gave up on that mentality of, you know, like I could appreciate those moments. Cool to watch everyone that like kind of whoever they roomed with became like buddies, you know. Like I watched Roberts and Justin become like good friends, you know. And I was looking at photos and they like got their arm around each other and it looks sick because, you know, Justin's the newest guy on the team and he really you know, made himself like part of the family. It was cool.
You know, when you go on tour, you don't know who you're going to be rooming with, so sat next to each other in the van and then he was just like, you want to share a room? And I was like, yeah. So we were roommates the whole tour. Even when we stayed at some family's house and we had bunk beds together. Yeah, it was good. It's rad. I mean, just skating different spots and just being completely out of your element. It's crazy. It's crazy. You're totally different lifestyle. When you go to a completely different spot, it's like you start just, your mind just starts going, you know? And I think that's what this trip did for me, is just got my brain just in skate mode.
know, I recognize on tours, kids just want to see the person. And like, there'd be demos that like, you know, I not maybe not even landed a trick. And after the demo, like, kids would be like, dude, Richard, you know, skated good. And I was like, I did not skate good, but I was thinking, you know what? All they wanted to see was you just be out there skating. And after just realizing that, like, every demo was just totally cool. Yeah.
I like hearing what kids say and think, you know. When they come up and talk to you, I definitely don't mind. Like, I'll sit and talk to kids all the time. Yeah, that whole crew was cool. I came back up the ramp and just like give high fives to everyone and give them, you know. I made sure those kids, because they were supporting me.
JB. Game planning, self-destruction and their production. Souls get sucked into the evil corruption. The odds of against me in the world won't protect me. Bad thoughts on my mind, but I won't let it take me. Organized confusion, negative illusion. I throw up my guard to combat intrusion. Say what? Say what? Say what? Jungle brother, cause I'm a jungle brother. Cause I'm a jungle brother. True blue brother.
Staying black and rhyming till the day that I'm dying. Death defying, chinky iron, and God I'm relying. Dressed up my import, make a million or more. Keep the radio rocking, fill up the dance floor. When we come to the jam, no glisten, no gimmicks. Break it off and you're right, till my style is no limits. Handle me. Like a true blue jungle G, I make the latest reply with a wink of an eye. Rhyme working, drive the lightning, MCs like this. Patience, here's with competition like slitting your wrist. Each sequel's only
up for the jam and rock it on for my people, cause I'm a jungle brother. Jungle brother. Jungle brother. Jungle brother. Cause I'm a jungle brother. Jungle brother. Jungle brother. Jungle brother. Ripping up.
There are some days when I'm skating and it's like almost like a sixth sense. You know, like one day you could skate horrible and the next day you wake up and you don't even stretch or anything, you know? It just feel like on point. I've never really like figured out like what I did to make it that way, but some days it's just that way.
Mark would show it up at a spot and skate around, just cruise, get warmed up. And then you'd see him just looking at it, staring, messing around with a few things, and then just he'll look at it some more. Just, you could just tell he's just, so many thoughts are going through his mind, like what can be done, like, you know, just like staring at it. And then all of a sudden, he'll just like come up with something, and you're just like, how did he come up with that? Like, what was his thought process to get that trick?
I have this kind of like this idea, if you think of something, you can do it. You know, skateboarding is ideas that are put into action. I mean, every time you do a trick, it's mostly in your head. You know, your body's just responding to what your head is telling it to do. You can do any trick you really want to, you put your mind to. If you try it long enough, or if you can think of it, you can pretty much do it on a skateboard.
he just had to wait for that right one, like trial and error. Like, as soon as I get in that right nose grind with the right speed, I'm just gonna whip this thing. And then he did, with flashes going off, Ollie shooting the photo. Oh, it was amazing. Yeah, that stokes you out. With us, we understand the big picture. So if anyone's busting something out, we're gonna be stoked. And on top of that, Mark just thought of that trick and did it. And to do it, get a sequence of it and film it, that's like what we all want to do.
It always has to be something new, dude, or I can't even roll. That's a problem I have.
Coming home, we were in the van, and it was a rad moment when, like, I got done driving. I took, like, the 1 o'clock to, like, 5:30, 6 o'clock shift or something like that, so the sun was just coming up. And we pulled over at a gas station to get gas, and then so everybody woke up, and everybody was in the van, and the sun was out. And we were just in the van on the way home, just all talking and just listening to music, and just, it was a good feeling, you know?
When you're driving, you're looking out the window, you know, like, well, I just experience this right now, because this will come to pass and it'll be a memory. That's what makes it that whole experience of being on that tour so rad. I really appreciate every moment being on that tour, spending time with those guys in that type of atmosphere, because there's only going to be one Hot Chocolate tour.
I always think, like, the age-old question, like, what am I doing? Why? What's my point here? Was my purpose in life to be a pro skateboarder? You know, all this time went by and I was just like kind of stuck in La La Land, wondering like, okay, what am I doing? Why am I here? I spent so long searching for a point that the last year and a half of my life has gone by in a blink. You know, I was too busy wondering about it. You miss your life. It goes by and like, you're like, wow, man, there is no tomorrow. There's what, like, you're gonna wake up tomorrow and it's not tomorrow anymore, it's now. All you have is right now.
There's no words to really describe like how the feeling was, you know? Just brothers from different mothers.
It was a great experience to be with all those guys, you know, and just ride a skateboard and just see what you can do on it, you know what I mean? And just to be on this and 10 years from now looking back at this, it would just be, I just would say, soak it up, boys, because these are some great memories right now. Don't get bummed, because you're going to look back and love this, you know. So I stay positive pretty much the whole time.
Feels like I got a lot of love at Chocalate, you know. And I've been on Chocalate since it started, so it feels like I'm more than part of just a team, you know what I mean? Like, they're part of your crew, and it's sick.
It was probably one of the best experiences like in my life so far. Like, I mean, that's pretty like a powerful thing to say. Like, I mean, a month out of my life, it was just such a good experience, and I had so much fun. Just, I might not remember the little things that happened, but the things that stand out in my mind now will probably stand out in my mind for like the rest of my life.
Yeah, luckily these trips and these videos and everything that we do, it's just such a good medium to like remind me of what I've done and to like have it and to be able to look back at it and be like, wow, you did this. You know, you're definitely filling our life up with some cool memories.
I look at skating as I dedicated so much of my life to it, but I could always look back on that and be proud that like this, like the thing I love to do, that the only reason why I'm doing it, I got to that pro level and traveled, it's just because I loved it so much. It wasn't because when I was a kid I was like, I want to be a pro skater and that's my goal and I gotta study, like, you know what I mean? It wasn't like that. It was just did it, kept doing it, and then things just like fell into place and my life fell into this hotel room right now. And I could look back at it and be like, you know, skateboarding, I hopefully left like a positive impact on it, and you know, I don't know, that's it.
ever since I rocked the knee, I think I ain't tripping on none of this stupid stuff no more. I don't get mad off of stuff like that. Like, as happy and joy I am, and like, I get that mad too. I'm sorry, I'm an emotional cat. You like the happy, but you don't want the sad. You better take it all. That's why I love Girl in Chocolate. They accepted all that shit. Like, oh, this dude's breaking another fucking board. He's not even mad about skating. Like, I'll focus a board. I'll be pissed at some dude cutting me off. I'll get out my car and break my board.
It's different. When I come out here, I skate with the guys, and now it's more, you know, for the last few years, it's been more kind of like I'm getting something done, you know, going out and handling something with handling and getting something done.
Chris got a package of powdered donuts and he put it on his lips, and Chris was doing like a cracked out, like cracky impression.
Yo guys, it's my turn to drive. I wanna drive. Yeah, I can make it all night.
And he just had these solid white lips.
They're gonna be cracking it.
Oh yeah, the Crail phone, man, that was just genius. Never thought of that. And no, they're just kids will call up and want to talk to, you know, whoever you want to talk to. Mark Johnson. Want to talk to Mark Johnson? It was always Mark Johnson. So he should have just had his own phone. We're going to do that next tour. We're going to do that. He's going to have his own phone. You can call Mark Johnson. You want to talk to Mark Johnson directly to him, you know?
We went to the Bjork concert, and then we had backstage passes. Next thing you know, she like throws a table on the ground or something for us to dance on, and the music's going, and then like just everybody's just in a full whirl, slam dancing to, she'd fall on the ground and everybody would fall on top of her, like, you know, like.
And then next thing I know, I'm getting called out to the dance floor. Skittles, come. So I ended up breakdancing. That was for Bjork's sake though. Then you have Birdman, Alice in Wonderland. We go back to the hotel. Scott and Gino were sick, so they didn't go. We knock on the door. I think Gino opens it, but he opens it and walks away. And then Allison jumps on the bed and is laying next to Scott. That photo alone just tells the whole story that night.
All love it so much, like it's such a, I don't know, it's like an escape, and like I get so psyched, like if I land a trick and like or like learn something new or just done something that I haven't done for a while, like I get that feeling all the time.
Like, what is that?